Josh Wagie is lucky to be alive.
Now, the vehicle went 40-some feet in the air, 120 feet forward, and was a catastrophic kill, as the Marine Corps described it.
Wagie suffered a concussion and had only 6 to 8 inches of his leg remaining below his knee.
God wasn't ready to take him home yet.
Getting hurt in the line of duty, Wagie earned the Purple Heart, but when he was about to be presented with the award, Wagie wasn't ready to accept it.
Josh said, no, I'd like to be standing on my own feet when you want to give me this award. And apparently the general said, well, we will respect your decision.
Wagie has been rehabbing at Walter Reed Medical Center in Bethesda, Maryland, since he returned to the U.S. shortly after getting injured. Josh's family visited him and saw firsthand that he is on his own rehab schedule.
The first day he was able to be on his knees, he hadn't been on his knees for a month.
And we got to see it.
He's fairly stiff in the knees, and all of a sudden, he had 35 degrees more range of motion, rolled on his stomach, realized he was on his knees, and his response was 50 quick push-ups. And his therapist just was smiling and shaking her head.
The community has been looking to help out the Wagie family ever since Josh's injuries. That includes the Fin and Feather Supper Club, where Josh used to work and many of his family members also have. They're offering 10% of today's income to the Wagie family to help them with expenses.
Employees kind of come and go. Some of them leave a mark on your hearts forever, and that's what the Wagie family did to us.
This was very touching.
The Wagies say the outpouring of support, like the benefit at the Fin and Feather Supper Club, will go a long way.
We just had some cement poured on the driveway to make getting in and out of vehicles easier for him when he's home. And when I told Josh that, he said, oh, so maybe we'll play some basketball at Christmas.
The rest of Wagie's unit will be returning from the war in December. He hopes to greet them off the plane, walking on his new 2 feet. In Fond du Lac County, Ben Krumholz, Fox 11 News.